Y amigos de TechCetera, estoy aquí con Joe Pine. Si ustedes están hablando de la experiencia de su cliente, el viaje de su cliente, Joe Pine estaba hablando de The Experience Economy desde finales del siglo pasado. Es como el papá de la teoría de la experiencia. Joe, thank you.
Thank you for being with us.
Thank you.
How
Pleasure.
are you?
I'm doing well, doing well.
We were just in El Focus On, and you were talking about the power of experiences, right? And how you can move from targeting markets and products to targeting or creating experiences and transformational experiences for your customers. You wrote your book 20 years ago.
20 years ago, right? This month, 20 years ago this
what
month.
What has changed in this 20 years?
Oh, so much. You know, so I used to have to argue 20 years ago on that we're shifting into an experience economy.
Okay.
And now I don't have to argue that anymore, right?
Everybody knows.
I just say it and the people go, yeah, of course. If they never heard it before, they go, of course. And so that's a big difference. And like every company is today almost getting into the experience economy, which was not the case 20 years ago. You can't keep up with all the examples that are going out there. There's all these new genres of experiences that keep appearing. And then in fact, you know, a lot of what I talked about today goes back to my book from 25 years ago, which is mass customization, about how you efficiently serve customers uniquely and giving everybody exactly what they want at a price they're willing to pay. And given all of what's going on is that we need to go from marketing to customering.
Okay.
Right, so it's a made-up word, customering, right? But you get the idea, and that means the market ways of marketing don't work because there are no markets; there are only customers.
We used to use markets because we didn't have enough information and enough means to individualize every person.
Right, and today we do.
Okay.
Right, today, particularly thanks to the power of digital technology, where we can interact with every individual customer. And understand their needs, keep track of it, keep a profile from them, and then respond by customizing our offerings to them as an individual. And that's at the core of what customering is all about, is that we work with individual customers, we understand them, and then we respond by customizing our offerings to them.
From your perspective on going to the customer individually, which new technologies are you interested in?
Yeah, yeah. One of many technologies out there. I'll talk about 3D printing.
Awesome.
I think has great possibilities. Still needs to come down in price and go up in speed. But you are able to get exactly what you want
when you want it.
3D printing. You know, talk about there's a digital modularity.
Yeah.
But 3D printing is the digital modularity of physical components.
Yeah.
Right. So you're putting the physicalness to it, which is you're programming matter in essence. And then also the other one is IoT, right? Internet of Things. Because now we can track things individually. We can know exactly where everything is. So like one of my favorite examples is Carnival Corporation that has this ocean medallion, an IoT device that every one of its guests can have on the cruise. And now I know who they are, I know where they are, I can respond to them individually.
It's like the Disney bands.
Yes, in fact, the CXO, the Chief Experience Officer at Carnival, John Padgett, came out of the work on the Disney bands,
okay.
Which was at least in part inspired by workshops that I did with Walt Disney World. And now with Carnival, he can do everything, because he couldn't do everything he wanted at Disney, now he can. So for example, they can even know that with the Ocean Medallion that when you're on the pool deck with your kids, your favorite drink is an iced tea with no lemon, but when you're in the bar with your buddies, it's a mojito, and when you're in the restaurant with your wife, it's a glass of Shiraz.
And you talked about this, each person has different markets.
Right, so it's what market am I in at the moment, right? That's core to customering. It's not just sensing responding to who I think you are, but we're all in different markets at different times. We want things in different ways at different times. And this allows us to be able to cater to that individual market within the individual customer.
At the appropriate moment.
Exactly.
One last question, and all of this has to do with what we're seeing and the fight throughout the last couple of years about privacy.
Mm-hmm.
And the deal that someone will take your information and make you do things that you wanted to do, or sell you things that you didn't need
right now.
Hey, it's so cool, I really like it. What's your take on this privacy versus personalization debate?
Excuse me. Well, research shows that when customers gain value from what the information they give you, they're more than willing to give that information.
Yeah.
But because they see the benefit, because you're using it to better the offering you have from them. But that's under the proviso that you keep it secure.
Yeah.
That you don't sell it to anybody else. You don't let it leak out there and so forth.
And that people know upfront that you're giving it, right?
Yeah, exactly, right? You got to be transparent about it. You got to know what you're tracking and what you're doing in that.
So you think that the GDPR in Europe and what California is doing on privacy, those are the ways to ensure that people will know and be enticed to give you the information for their benefit?
I think maybe they go a little too far in some areas, okay. But certainly directionally, we need to get to the point where the customer owns their own data.
Yeah.
Right, where they recognize that.
Especially like data. In medical records and something that's begun to this journey of digitization. Right,
right, exactly.
Okay.
What's next for you?
For me,
yeah.
Well, we're coming out with a new hardcover of The Experience Economy in the fall.
Okay.
It's going to have the subtitle of Competing for Customer Time, Attention, and Money, which is what you have to do in The Experience Economy. We just finished a preview for it last couple weeks. And then I want to take what we've talked about today on customering, going from marketing to customering, turn that into a full book, plus write a significant article on time.
Okay.
And the importance of time. Not our time, but customer time. Yeah. As the
new currency.
Right. It's the most precious resource in the world.
Awesome. Thank you very much. Right. Awesome time yesterday and today.
All right, pleasure. Thank you.